The Kurds, also known as Kurdish people, are one of the largest ethnic groups in the world, native to the Middle East without a nation of their own. For nearly a century ago, the Kurds have been struggling for independence, political rights, and autonomy. Their struggle for the creation of Kurdish independence continues until this day. The total number of Kurds today is 35 million strong. So who and where are the Kurds? They are spread across parts of Syria, Iraq, Iran, Turkey, Armenia, and a significant part of the population migrated largely to Europe and other countries around the globe. Kurds have their unique language. The language they speak is called Kurdish, and there are three different major dialects of this spoken language. They have their scripts, their own culture, and tradition. However, many Kurds still identify themselves as a distinct ethnic group, while others as being Kurds. The majority of Kurds today consider themselves as Sunni-Muslims by religion, while the minority identified as Shias, and a smaller group is adherent to other religions. This is how the Kurdish flag looks like. Red represents the bloodshed of the martyrs in the continuous fight for independence and freedom. White symbolizes both peace and equality, and the green color stands for the country's natural and beautiful landscapes. Lastly, the yellow symbol here at the center, the sun, it holds both religious and cultural significance among the Kurds since ancient times. The sun has 21 rays that express the Kurdish New Year, known as Nowruz, which is celebrated every year on March 21st. I know these important things, and I have this beautiful flag because I'm Kurdish, a very proud one, born in Syria. But 20 years ago, my parents immigrated from Syria to Sweden. So I think of myself as a Swedish Kurd. As my mom has explained over the years, they migrated for various causes, such as political reasons, extreme poverty, a lack of belief in the future, and beyond. Speaking of Syrian Kurds, as we've learned during the Syrian civil war in 2011, many civilians were forced to leave their homes, and millions fled their country to escape conflict. Among these people, a large number were Syrian Kurds. But as time has passed, there is still no safety for Kurds in Syria today, and times of sorrow and heartbreaks continue. When it comes to Iraqi Kurds, life is different. Between 5 and 6 million people live in Iraqi Kurdistan. Kurdistan, which means the land of Kurds, is an autonomous region today, with its parliament, government, and own security force known as Peshmerga, where the Peshmerga is a Kurdish word that means those who confront death. And among many of those who confront death in Kurdistan are women. The force of Peshmerga is estimated to be between 300,000 and 350,000 male and female fighters. So the question is, what do all the Kurds want? The ultimate goal is a united and sovereign country, but there still isn't much support for it, even though Kurds deserve and have the rights to an official homeland of their own, where all Kurds can call it home.